What's up everyone, Terraquake here, and I am back with another top 5 favorite Pokemon video. And so far, I've gone through the first 4 generations of Pokemon and listed my top 5 favorite Pokemon from each of those regions. So now it is time to do the Unova region. Now just like the first 4 videos in this series, I will be including the whole entire regional Pokedex, which includes starters, mythicals, legendaries, every single Pokemon from the Unova region. And I do want to go and give you guys a heads up, a lot of Pokemon on this list are sort of based off of coolness, because I think a lot of Pokemon from the Unova region are pretty cool, and I know some people hate on the region because it was sort of a, like, soft reboot for Pokemon, and some people just don't like it, how it copied Kanto, but I like it. And also, I will be giving out some honorable mentions, like always, but without further ado, let's get started. I do only have 2 honorable mentions, and the first one is Cobalion. And first of all, I like the Swords of Justice. I think they're one of the cooler legendary trios out of really all of legendary trios. But Cobalion is my favorite out of the 3. I like its typing of Steel Fighting. And I actually used one the first time I played through Pokemon Black 2. And usually I don't use a legendary on my teams, but for some reason Cobalion, he got on my team and he was just a beast. I loved him. And so he gets an honorable mention. And my last honorable mention goes to Duwot. And Duwot has the amazing origin of being based off of an otter and a samurai. Like, that is just so sick. And also, I think it is the coolest looking one out of any of the starters. And that includes the beginning stages, the middle stages, and final stages. I don't know why. Just has, like, that perfect look to it. Intimidating, while so cute. And, yeah, it deserves my last honorable mention. To start this list off, we have Excadrill. And I've said it before, the steel typing is my favorite type in Pokemon. And Excadrill has that perfect mix, how even though it's steel typing, it's also ground, which is pretty cool. But its defenses are good, and its attack is just great. And I like that about him. I like that, you know, Drillbur evolves into it not too late in the game, which is pretty nice. And I like how Clay uses it on his team as a signature Pokemon. Excadrill, just a really cool looking Pokemon, intimidating, looks awesome, and a very good Pokemon. Especially, I think it's used well in competitive play as well, so it has that going for it too. So Excadrill gets the number 5 spot. Eluding in at number 4, we have Zoroark. And I just like this thing because of all the crazy theories that people have about it. It might not be the coolest looking Pokemon, it's probably the least cool Pokemon on this list, but just the theories that it has, I mean, there's a theory that Zoroark is actually N, and there's actually a lot of evidence. Even though it sounds crazy, there's a lot of evidence to back it up. Also, like how when you go into the Lost Lorne Forest, there's that creepy backpacker that as soon as he starts walking away, he's actually a Zoroark. I remember when I first saw that just sort of blew my mind. And I've always found that Zoroark is just an interesting Pokemon, even though it's not the coolest looking one, it's pretty interesting. And I feel like we need more answers. Game Freak, we need more answers about Zoroark. Crawling its way into the number 3 spot is Scolipede. And Scolipede is just a cool looking Pokemon, and I know I've said cool a lot already in this video, but that's the only way to describe a lot of the Unova Pokemon. And I also like how it's not that weak, you know, 3-stage bug Pokemon, sort of like Caterpie, Metapod, Butterfree. It's, you know, Venipede, Whirlipede are also 2 very good Pokemon. And I don't know, I just like what it's based on, and I have used one before. Very good, a fast attacker, and that's one of my favorite types of Pokemon, and I've said before, a fast attacker, you know, those are one of my favorite types. So Scolipede is in at the number 3 spot. Coming in at the runners-up spot on this list, we have Darmanitan. And this thing is just a flat-out beast. We all know its stats are so good. It is a fire orangutan, because that's what it's based on. It's just awesome, bro. I don't even know. It's attacking. It's just great. It's a beast Pokemon. I have recently used it before, and it was probably my best Pokemon on my team, and that's even going over my starter and everything. So yeah, this thing, I mean, basically, what, a fire orangutan. So good. I like its pre-evolution, too, and I like how you can get it pretty early on in the game. You can get Darumaka right after Castellia City, which is pretty awesome. So, you know, you get it pretty early on. You can level it up, and evolve it into this beast. Oh man, Darmanitan, can't go wrong with it. Even if you have a full team of fire types, I bet you'll still win with this thing, because it can also learn a ton of other moves too. And Darmanitan gets the runners-up spot. And my number one favorite Pokemon in the Unova region is Krookodile. And this thing is just awesome. It is a final stage form of Sandile. It is a dark ground type, which is a type combination that I like a lot. And I like it in the anime. I know a lot of people say, ooh, it copied Squirtle, it has the glasses, oh my gosh, it sucks. No, I don't care if it copied Squirtle. It looks better in the glasses than Squirtle does. There, I said it, it looks better than Squirtle in the glasses. I think it's just awesome Pokemon, and I've used one before. It is a beast, it is an all-around good Pokemon. And yeah, I mean, it's a cool looking Pokemon. If you saw my top 5 favorite Johto Pokemon video, you would know that Feraligatr was my number one favorite Pokemon there. So you can already tell that I like sort of the alligator crocodile type Pokemon, and there is no exception for Krookodile. So he is my number one favorite Pokemon out of all the Pokemon in the Unova region. So there it is. Those were my top 5 favorite Pokemon in Generation 5. If you guys enjoyed, don't forget to like and subscribe. It'll let me know that you guys enjoy these types of videos. And I'll keep on making them. I mean, next up is Kalos. We only have 3 generations left. But for now, I hope you guys enjoyed. And I will see you all next time.